we did an all mountain world, but this is an all farmland world. So you can build farms anywhere, I guess. Doesn't matter if it's a desert or mountain or, I don't know, islands. Everyone has farmlands, and I don't really know what that means. All I know is this is a really strange game. I know farmland has to help in terms of, like, conflict and battles and things like that, but also, I think it helps with your development, maybe, like, increasing stuff, making your cities better. You can play taller or something. I don't know. But like I said, by the end, there were just so many nations in the top 8 that I'm really not used to seeing, and that's what made this such a weird world. I don't even know how to explain it. Like I said, it should be a lot easier for the AI, because now they can just throw their troops at whatever and never have to worry about attacking into a really, like, defensive location. Everything is just kind of like an open field or something like that. Okay, we're not gonna waste any time here. We're gonna jump right into it. We've got France being sieged out by England and Poland doing something really weird to Hungary, and I don't know how long that's gonna last because Poland's having some trouble, so is Lithuania. Ming is already dead, just like that. That might be the fastest collapse of Ming we've ever seen, and honestly at this point I'm rooting for him. I am rooting for Ming to stay around. Please, one day, I want a powerful Ming again. I know it's kind of weird because I was probably like the biggest person that would complain about how Ming would always just be super overpowered. Now things are reversed. I just don't like the same thing all the time. I need some different things to happen. Oh, I've never seen this blue nation before. Never even heard of that blue nation. So we'll see if they survive Ethiopia, and then these guys who tend to do pretty good, they're still around and they're probably gonna give them some trouble. Morocco has not been a problem for the Iberians so far, and Granada's already been kicked out. I'm assuming maybe there has been no wedding yet, so Aragon still controls Naples. So Spain still has a while to go. Oh, this is why France is so screwed. No wonder. Burgundy hasn't collapsed and or been annexed by Austria or Spain. They're still okay, although for some reason they'd never stand a chance. Dang, Bohemia's fully sieged out. Oh, who you got? Ming or Ning? Ning is a newcomer, I guess, a twin or something. I like Ning's color a lot more. Boom, little cameo from Tibet. Let's see if they survive. They were formed actually, so someone out here is doing pretty good. Mamluks once again attacking the Ottomans and having some success, but let's not count out the Ottomans. It's definitely possible they come back with time. They just gotta survive. Holy crap, look at these guys, and they're like jumping across Mamluk territory. I thought this was them for a second there, but yeah, interesting. And this blue nation's still here, or whatever color that is, I don't even know. 100 Years War is not going well at all. France might be killed immediately. Austria has annexed, like, Croatian territory. That's a little new, not used to that. Naples has been annexed, so we have Aragonese Italy. So I think Aragon will likely keep their independence, not entirely sure though. And here goes Russia. So they're gonna kind of maneuver around the hordes as best they can. Are we gonna finally see a good Russia? I feel like it's always been the Commonwealth. Commonwealth clearly is not gonna do very good here. Poland started so strong too. Look at this. I don't know, they must have went through some terrible civil war or something like that. Looks like, oh, Lithuania lost a bunch of troops, land. So Lithuania is independent clearly. Wow, this is really bad. It is just continuing to get worse. Also Aragon lost a bunch of territory. Pope's doing okay, and Bohemia was completely sieged out. Look at that, you just never know what's gonna happen. Not really used to the Inca colonizing. Is that normal? That is not normal. So is the farmlands helping? I mean, they can farm on anything, right? They're used to farming on these Andes Mountains. That's what it's called, right? See, the Ottomans are already back, and they're pushing back the Mamluks, and the Mamluks aren't even looking that good. Iraq is here. Timmy is becoming the Mughals. They haven't formed that green nation yet, but they probably will soon. Japan has eaten Korea before they've even unified their island. So, I mean, that's kind of common. They just have a couple more to eat away. Oda's actually still doing pretty good. Nice bald Oda man. Russia has reached the Pacific Ocean, and now it's time to just roll over all the hordes. Wait, don't the hordes get messed up because of the farmland? I'm assuming it's This has got to be bad, I think, right? Very complicated situation in Scandinavia. We had Denmark annex Norway. Norway get their freedom. Sweden kill Norway. And now they're looking like they might form like a Scandinavia, or it's a Nordic country at this point. Holland in Greenland. Why have we never seen that before? I don't even know. I didn't even know Holland existed. I don't know why I said that weird. And Holland's also down here in Canada. Holland, Canada. That is actually kind of a perfect combination. Oh, and there go the Inca. So the Portuguese are doing a bunch of damage here. We're not even gonna worry about this too much until people get independent, because unless something insane happens, which I doubt it. But we do already have Australia. Just a regular old Australia. Great Britain has gotten here, and they're not independent, obviously. Let's see if they get to New Zealand as well. Some funky things happening in the subcontinent of India, that is for sure. Not used to seeing these yellow guys get pushed all the way down like that. The Baham The Bahamas? I've always just wanted to call them the Bahamas, can I? They seem to be the strong nation here. No Ming or Ning, and that's probably for the best, because ultimately all these nations are going to get taken out. Just depends by who. The Timurids, or Russia, maybe Japan. Japan, kind of unlikely though. Oh my god! Okay, Savoy, what is going on here? I was about to talk about the Ottomans, but no, this is way more important. So, Savoy, France. We now have Savoy, France. We also got a nice blobby HRE, which, you know, by the way, at the end, it looks like Burgundy might have gotten inherited by Austria. But Saxony looking like the sexiest. I don't even know where Bohemia went. But yeah, I do want to just finish by saying the Ottomans are terrifying, but that's fine. That's kind of normal. Savoy still got a long way to go. They have a lot of borders to clean up. And the weird thing is, so we saw France collapse. How did they get rid of the British, though? Did the British... Oh, well, there's... Our answer, Wales and a bunch of other random places are released, so something terrible must have happened. Really liking the Scandinavia, though. They're going to give Russia a lot of trouble, which the Russians are probably worried about the Uzbek right now, and maybe Manchu. And Kong is one of the last remaining people trying to survive Morocco's onslaught. Also, not used to that, but okay, it's a new combination. So we've got Spanish Canada, or I guess Castilian Canada, because Spain never formed. Also Florida, British Mexico, British Cascadia, Portuguese Louisiana, and some weird kind of things happening in South America. But yeah, nothing too crazy. Japan still hasn't kicked out Oda, and Oda is like, how did they get down towards these islands or factions? Do they just group together? So I don't even know what's gonna happen to Japan. That's kind of terrible for them. Look at poor, depressing Poland. But at the same time, at least they are surviving. They're doing okay. Dang, Scandinavia's getting even more territory. They might become the new Russia. It's looking like it. Especially because the Russians are having some trouble. Clearly, Timmy is, Timmy's not exploding this time around. And I'm just wondering, like, when is he gonna form his nation? Cause you know it happens. It has happened like every time. Oh my God. Please calm down. Malaya was now formed down here. Kind of like that. Also, I'm seeing some Savoy provinces. But yeah, this country's nice and all. It's not like they're gonna survive though. Europeans are coming. It's kind of weird the British got to Australia so fast, but then they allowed other people to colonize the rest. Ottoman top ends. That sounds weirdly sexual. And then we also have the Dutch Western Australia. That's interesting. Okay, you know, maybe Castile will form Spain. They're at least getting really, really close, although now they're having problems with Morocco, so it's like back and forth. Aragon might be fine, though, here in the Italian peninsula. Savoy gotta get a little bit more going, though. I mean, it's nice that, you know, they got Brittany, but hopefully they can get, like, a colony or two, because the Ottomans are coming for them. Look how close they are to each other. That's amazing. Bam! It looks like British Mexico got their freedom, or they're getting their freedom, right? The color is a little weird. So I wouldn't be surprised, because clearly the British are having a lot of trouble. There's no other reason why those nations would be released. But you know who else is having trouble? Russia. Russia is dead, pretty much. Oh, there they go. Okay, so this is the new Russia, clearly. Scandinavia should also benefit from this, and maybe even Lithuania. Lithuania can come back if they have a nice friend. Also, who are these guys? I don't think I've ever seen this name before. Ardabil. Ardabil. I'm guessing their capital's probably like, they're probably like a single province and they got like huge, maybe. All right, I have never seen this nation expand the way they've expanded. They just went straight up north, and they're splitting off everyone. Now they're gonna have trouble in India. I guarantee you that. Castile basically has a bunch of like Bangladesh territory. Bangladesh, also Savoy's here. So Savoy is doing some colonization. I think that is the Pope as well. There's probably a couple others. Savoy's over here in Indochina, and we have the Mughals out here in the coast. How did they get here in the coast? You guys got coastland over here? Oh yeah, you do a little bit. Can Saxony form Germany? I have no idea. Oh, I just realized, wow, I almost missed that. Savoy grabbed Wales. Not sure how they did that, but they completely grabbed Wales. And then how'd they get that? I have no idea. Scotland is now free. Savoy's pretty powerful, guys. You wanna calm down? Portugal's also getting taken out by Castile very slowly, so it's only, you know, safe to assume. Oh, wow. The Pope got a bunch of, they're kicking Aragon out of Italy. Oh yeah, there goes Portugal right now. So they already lost, like, I think all their colonies, didn't they? Except for Louisiana. Louisiana's gonna leave too, though. So, yeah, the battle's begun in the Western Hemisphere. Love that Holland remains in Canada, though. How did they not get kicked out by the Castilians? And Greenland. Hey, as long as you hold on to that, you're my winner. Okay, yeah, can almost confirm that these guys don't start anywhere near this large, obviously. But now they are huge. They have a wall. They've walled off from the Caspian Sea to almost up here. I don't know if they're gonna survive, but you know, good job. Oh, maybe that's why Scandinavia is doing so well. They've got the entire HRE on their side, which would explain a lot. Maybe they need to worry about the Ottomans right now. The Ottomans just keep on growing. We have a formed Indian nation that's just popped up, and they are gonna be in a tough spot because they're surrounded by like Castilian Bengal and also Savoy, Pakistan, basically. Pakistan. It's called Western India, but yeah, okay. Yeah, Malaya's not having a fun time anymore. They've been buying or selling off provinces to a bunch of people, including the Pope. The Pope's out here doing a whole lot. Holland with the douche move. Basically, the British almost had all of New Zealand, and then they came in here and grabbed this just to stop them, just to cause some terrible border gore. That's beautiful. Savoy surprisingly even grabbed a colony out here in Central America. I don't know if it's a colony yet, but it's getting closer. So they beat someone back, probably a collapsing Mexico, because clearly Mexico is collapsing. How did I miss this? Qing China has formed. Oh no, they might be dead already. But I know I said I wanted Ming to do good. Qing China's a pretty good replacement though. And Japan is still sucking, look at that. And you know what, this isn't even Oda up here. That's the British. The British have the Northern Island. Okay, you guys are terrible. The Mongols are doing incredible, and at this point, whoa. Maybe not anymore. At this point, I was gonna say they might kick off everyone, but it's looking like they might just lose everything. Never mind. Savoy's got a pretty nice Indochina, so does the Ottomans. The Ottomans are expanding in Burma. We've got Castilian Bengal still, which is getting bigger, especially as this northern horde collapses. They are losing everything right before our eyes. This Blue Nation, which I don't even know if it's blue. This is like turquoise, right? I'm not good with colors, but they've survived the entire time, and they're still looking okay. They got all of Ethiopia. Maybe they'll go up off the coastline of East Africa. That'd be a nice change of pace. Never would never seen that. Here goes the US and Canada, both getting released at the same time. This is probably because Spain did terrible back at home. But there's also New Great Britain. That wasn't a thing. New Great Britain formed out of a crumbling Mexico like we talked about. And South America is going to be a battle between Chile and Peru, both started by the Portuguese. Castilian Brazil is going to get kicked out. And then English Colombia, I don't expect that to survive for much longer. There we go. Savoy, Mexico. Savoyard. I've never heard of that term before, but Savoyard, Mexico is now a thing. Cool. The British have just allowed both Holland and the Ottomans to stay in Australia. And Holland and New Zealand. That's very friendly of them. They're probably having a lot of issues. That's right, Savoy's taking land from them back at home. Taking a lot of land from them back at home. They have now connected their territories. They had this random, they had Hull, right? Hull, and then they had Wales, and then they just, I don't know, they did things together. This is not Scandinavia, by the way. This is like that Scottish, old Scottish nation. Still love how Holland has casually just stayed under the radar this entire time. Please make it to the end, Holland. Now that Canada's independent, it's probably gonna be a little bit harder, but I don't know, we'll see. Poland's still holding on, even though Lithuania got taken out a long time ago. Also, Scandinavia is losing territory to, I'm assuming they're Persian, maybe Persian, something like that. Hamburg, Korea, never thought I'd say that. That is definitely new. Also, the Philippines, of course, is just a giant gang bang. We got Portugal and the Ottomans and Brunei for some reason, and Castile. I don't know, it's a weird mixture. India's still holding strong, although they haven't picked up any new territory from the crumbling nation up here, which they might not be crumbling anymore. They could have stopped that. Castile was just revolutionary not that long ago, so that explains why they lost some territory to all these other different people. And then Savoy cutting into HRE. Things are getting serious now. I actually don't even know if the HRE is still a thing at this point. I mean, probably, maybe. US is looking like they might lose to Canada. We see this all the time because Canada's got like the protection of nothing up here. The North, they tend to win. I don't know why. New Great Britain just grabbed every, wait a second. No, that is Mexico and California. And oh, you're losing, you lost Texas. Okay, so Savoy stole away British colonies. We'll see if they got Australia. Savoy did lose a war though. Normandy got released somehow. Qing China's still looking strong, and I really like that. I want to see them just take, well, they could take all of Russian lands, or if they just take all of this, that'd be good too. And I think they have, don't they have like a casus belli? Don't they have like a way to go to war with all these nations? Something like that. Once again, we have English Columbia and also British Columbia. Little different spelling there, but I mean, it is English, British, I guess there's different, and this the spelling, what can you say? Once again, Hamburgian Congo. That sounds tasty. I would not mind some Hamburgian Congo. What name is that? Who are you guys? That is definitely a nation I'm not used to. Wow, I completely almost forgot that these guys started here. Like, I was like, wait, what is that? This Congo? That's such a better Congo. I'm sorry that I just completely skipped over you. Prussia has left their little smash spot in between Poland. They have a little bit, actually. And they've moved up towards Scandinavia. As Scandinavia continues to crumble, Denmark is now released, so we'll see if, like, Sweden or Norway make an appearance. This might be the most disgusting Central America we've seen this late into the game. It's pretty late. We're, like, in the 20th century, and it's really bad. Why aren't the AI taking down, like, Aztec nations anymore? Oh, my... We have Indian Mexico now. That's the level we're on. Okay, I'm gonna assume these guys are probably really powerful. They've also kicked out Savoy from Pakistan. Oh my god. And they've taken Castile and Bengal. Not a surprise, because Castile's been kind of sucking. Qing looking amazing, as well as a couple of other places, I guess. But I really like Qing. Let's just hope to keep going. There's really barely any Europeans still left over here. Oh no. Oh no. We're seeing the fall of Savoy. That's depressing, because we've seen Morocco form these guys many times, but we do not normally see a Savoy France. Savoy France, I will always love you. My heart is forever yours, something, I don't know. Poland becoming Poland again, though. Look at this blobby-ass Poland. I like this. They are doing it without even Lithuania. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. Russian, Russia. Russian, Russia. What a way with words. Now we got a revolutionary Ottomans. I've already seen there's been like two or three different revolutionary nations at this point, so things are getting pretty crazy. Also, didn't realize that Cyprus was controlled by Savoy. Had to get that. Papal South China is probably the biggest colony left in Asia, besides Ottoman Burma, actually, because not a whole lot. Ottoman North China is not bad either, and Hamburgian Korea, but yeah, kind of funny to see the Pope is one of the bigger ones over here. Tibet is now back, but that doesn't matter. Tibet comes and goes whenever they please. Japan kind of unified their island, but not really, because they still got to kick the British out of here, and I don't think they're going to do that. The British got Hawaii. I was kind of wondering if, like, India was going to take Hawaii. That'd explain a lot why they have Mexico right now, but I don't know. It's kind of a nice just to look at who has this. Oh, wow. Indian Mexico didn't last at all. It barely did. They're just Indian Baja California at this point, and I don't think there's any coming back. Oh, you terrible Canadians. How could you do that to Holland? You guys would be best friends. Don't lie. I know Spanish Canada would love Holland. Greenland Holland and Canadian Holland. I don't know. Qing is in this island. Qing is in North America right now. That might be the only thing better than having an Indian Mexico, honestly. Ottomans clearly been having trouble at the end here, which is obvious. That's why they've become revolutionary. But at the same time, ooh, they were taken. Oh, these guys got all the way up through Scandinavia. They were doing amazing. And they're probably going to lose a lot now. What a depressing Holy Roman Empire map. Look how much land they controlled before. And now they're just a sad existence of their former self. Let's see who won. Okay, well, you know what? Savoy at least got into 8th place. I mean, they were probably much higher than this before, but I'll take that. Savoy hasn't ranked in a while. These Persians are a greater power than the US, which could be the biggest twist of all. Actually, Canada's not even on this list, but that's kind of weird. Chile, and then the nation from the Arabian Peninsula. Like I said, like, there's so many names I'm just not used to. And then bam, we have India, or this world's India, and revolutionary Ottomans. Man, they could have fallen. Oh, they were way ahead. Never mind. They probably weren't gonna fall. That was gonna take some time, but, well, India probably would have caught them eventually, though. Very depressed that Qing didn't get on there. Maybe with some more time. I mean, Korea's now released. You could eat up Korea, maybe. Or did you release Korea? I can't even remember. But there's definitely a lot of land for them to go. If we kept going, they could eat up a lot of things. Maybe next time. I'm really liking Qing. Please, just, if Ming could just survive once, I'd be happy just one time. And no one fully unified Oceania. Look how divided Oceania is. And it's like the British didn't even want to get that together. I mean, again, they've still had problems with Savoy. Who are these guys? Portuguese? Oh yeah, Philippines still a mess. Culture doesn't really change that much unless someone, like, colonizes something weird, and then, yeah, something like that. But faith has. Faith has been weird. We still have, like, Incan faith in South America for some reason. And, well, Hindu's around, but I don't believe that Indian nation is Hindu, something like that. I really don't know what kind of effects these farmlands had. Maybe some people can come up with some theories down below. But for some reason, they were allowing really weird nations to do good. And a lot of, like, risings and falls. I don't know why I can't speak. But that was a weird one. I definitely enjoyed this game. That was so strange. Thanks for watching. See you next time. A big thanks to Vinny Chang, A. Mikey, Pelofsky, Vincent S., Free Cruise, Junior0915, Daddy Kim, Supreme Leader of the Universe, Lol Knight, Ballin' Like Star, Birthday Daddy, Fleeper56, Mega Fat Boy 2.0, Hentai Lover, Time, Brendan H, Cooter Donkey, Pizza, Maxi G, Swiss Argo, Usurication, Elijah Senpai, and LPC. Thank you.